Hey everyone, so for today's tutorial, I'm gonna be using the Alamar Cosmetics Reina Del Caribe eyeshadow palette. This is the volume one, and this is a beautiful palette. This is what it looks like, and it's a really pretty summery palette. So I'm probably gonna use some of these blue shades today, and actually I'll try to use as many colors in the palette as I can. So the first shade I'm gonna go into is this warm orange color called Coco Taxi, and I'm gonna take that on a big fluffy blending crease brush, and I'm just gonna blend this through the crease as our transition shade. So this palette is currently my palette of the month. So if you're new to my channel, basically every month I choose an eyeshadow palette to kind of focus on and just to get a lot of use out of throughout the month. And at the end of each month, I will do a Shadow Saturday series look with my palette of the month so that you guys can really see how it performs and also just get inspired of ways to use this palette if you have it in your collection, or even just picking similar shades out of your collection from this. Next, I'm gonna go into this more purple berry tone shade, and I'm not even gonna try to pronounce this name. I'm just taking that on a little bit smaller of a fluffy crease brush, and I'm just gonna be packing this on the outer corner and also a little bit on the inner corner because I'm gonna be doing kind of a halo eye today. So I'm also, once I get all the excess product off the brush, I'm gonna blend it through the crease just to kind of connect those. And I really love this palette. It has some really unique shades like this gold green shade, which we're also going to be using today. The matte shades are also really pigmented and easy to blend. And I just think this palette has some really good variety. This palette does have a mix of warm and more cooler tones, but I find that all these shades kind of go really well together, even though they're kind of a mixture and you wouldn't really think they would go, some of them would go well together, but they really do. So it's hard to mess up a look with this palette. Now I'm gonna move on to the lid shades, and I'm gonna take this deep blue shade called Veradero, and I'm just taking it on a little flat shader like lid brush. I'm actually going to spray my brush just with a little bit of water I have in a spray bottle because I don't wanna get fallout with this shade, but I'm gonna pack it kind of close to the outer corner, but also letting a little bit of that deep outer corner shade show through. So I'm not going all the way to the outer corner, and then also I'm kind of mirroring it on the other side next to the inner corner. So I'm not going all the way to the inner corner, but pretty close to it. And don't worry about like blending this together because we will go back in and kind of blend it and make sure there's no harsh edges later. Then I'm gonna go into this lighter blue called Celia, and this is a beautiful shade as well. It's almost like a seafoam greeny blue, and I'm just taking that on the other side of that same brush, and I'm also gonna spray this just to make sure I don't get any fallout on my face. And I'm gonna put this basically right next to that deeper blue shade, and I'm actually gonna put this kind of just all over the lid. And I really don't know if this look is gonna turn out well. It looks a little bit rough right now, but hopefully it'll come together in the end. I never really plan these looks. I just kind of wing it with all of these, so just hoping that it turns out well. And I really love these metallic shades. They're super metallic and intense. So now I'm gonna go back in with that smaller blending crease brush that we had that berry tone on, and I'm just gonna kind of go in and blend the edges of this a little bit, just very lightly. And I'm actually gonna take a little bit more of that shade on my brush just to blend that easier. And while we're here, I'm also just gonna take that brush with a little bit of that berry tone, and I'm gonna blend it under the lower lash line, only going about halfway in. So I'm just gonna go back in with that flat shader brush we had the metallic shades on, and I'm just gonna pack those on again because I feel like we lost some of that metallic intense sheen. So I'm just gonna pack those on the lid again. I'm gonna take another little flat shader brush, and I'm going to go into this green gold shade here. Again, not even gonna try to pronounce the name of it, but I'm just gonna take a little bit of that, and I'm just, actually I am gonna wet this as well just so I don't get fallout. And I'm gonna pack this right on the center of the lid just to give it a little bit of a pop right there. Then with a little pencil brush, I'm gonna go into the shade La Costa right here, which is just a really pretty metallic pinkish color. And I'm gonna use this as my inner corner highlight and also my brow bone highlight. And I'm also gonna take this up sort of into the crease a little bit, what Ali Glines calls a scoopity boopity, and just to kind of really highlight that inner corner and give a lot of light there. The other day I did a look with this palette and it turned out beautiful with these two, this blue shade and then this greenish gold shade, and I didn't use a wet brush or anything. I actually think I just used my finger and there was a lot of fallout on my face, but since we used a wet brush with the metallic shades, there wasn't any fallout. So I would either recommend using a wet brush or really just doing your eyes first so that you're safe with fallout and you can just wipe it away easily. So now I'm just gonna go off camera and fill in my brows and also put on mascara and I'll be right back. So here is the finished look, and after looking up close, I did notice that there was some fallout, so I would really recommend doing your eyes first if you're gonna be using, especially with blues, because when you get blue fallout, it's even worse because it just accentuates your under eyes and makes you look even more tired and kind of just doesn't look right, obviously, because it's blue. So I would really recommend doing your eyes first. I don't know how I feel about the way this look turned out. It's not my favorite. I mean, the more I look at it, it is pretty, but I don't know. Let me know what you guys think down below in the comments. And I hope you enjoyed this video. I will have my Shadow Saturday series playlist linked down below, along with all my other playlists, so you guys can go watch those. And if you did enjoy this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And I post new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday, so make sure to stay tuned for those. And if you want to see more from me, make sure to subscribe, and don't forget to hit that bell icon to get notified every time I post. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.